Good morning, Michelle and Minda and Kenny. Good to start the day with a little Kirk Franklin. Good morning. It's good to be with you this morning on Prayer and Devotion, May 16th. Saturday. It's good to see Tony and Michelle and Minda and Kemi and Daniel. I'm glad you're able to get on today. I'm glad to have all of you here with me. And Les. Hi, Les. Today we are looking at the word encouragement. Encouragement. And Hillary and Pastor Joe did such a nice job the last 2 days. But it is good to be back here with you today. And so the scripture we're looking at today comes, it's a just a short scripture from Acts, the Acts of the Apostles. It is believed that the same writer of the Gospel of Luke also wrote Acts of the Apostles, which tell the story of how the church came into being. Good morning, Esther. And and today's passage comes from Acts 4, and it talks of a man whose name was Barnabas. And this is Acts chapter 4, verse 36. So if you'd like to take out your Bibles, each day we pick a word. If this is your first time with us, my name is Cindy Stauffer. I'm the pastor of the United Methodist Church at New Brunswick. And good morning, Priscilla. And each day we gather to look at a word that'll root us in scripture. Good morning, Gert. And today's word is encouragement. Encouragement. And the scripture comes from Acts chapter 4, verse 36. There was a Levite, a native of Cyprus, Joseph, to whom the apostles gave the name Barnabas, which means son of encouragement. So Barnabas's name was actually Joseph. Barnabas means encourager or son of encouragement. So today we are looking at the word encouragement and what that means in each of our lives. Good morning, Rosetta and Joyce. It's good to have you here. So it's day 35, and we're looking at day 35 in our time of Eastertide, which takes us from Resurrection Sunday all the way up to Pentecost. I cannot believe we are only 15 days away from Pentecost. But we're looking at a book called Pauses for Pentecost, 50 Words for Easter People by Trevor Hudson. And this is what Trevor says about the word encouragement. Recently, I have noticed how many of our conversations are riddled with discouragement. Discouragement about the political future of our country, about the work we do each day, about our closest relationships, and most painfully, about our journey with God. Few things have more power to rob us of joy and happiness than being discouraged. This realization gets me thinking. As Easter people empowered by the Spirit, one of the most important ministries we are called to exercise today is the ministry of encouragement. One of the unsung heroes of the early church is Barnabas. Joseph is his real name, but as the apostles watch him interact with people, they rename him Barnabas, which means son of consolation or son of comfort. Elsewhere in the book of Acts, Luke describes him as a good man, full of the Holy Spirit and faith. And by his witness, a great number of people were brought to the Lord. As we entrust our lives to the Lord, his Spirit enables us to encourage people around us. Certainly, this is the case with Barnabas. Hopefully, it can be true for us as well. How did Barnabas exercise the ministry of encouragement? A quick glance at the times Luke mentions him in Acts gives us helpful clues. First, when he brings the newly converted Paul to the fearful and suspicious leadership of the church in Jerusalem, he acts as a mediator in Acts 9:27. Bridging gaps and bringing healing between conflicting parties can be a huge source of encouragement for those involved. Secondly, he constantly affirms followers of Christ who live faithfully and stand firm in their faith, and he expresses appreciation for them. You can find that in Acts 11:23. Third, he goes against Paul's advice and gives a young, impetuous John Mark a second chance in Acts 15:38 through 39. Can you think of someone you can bless today through encouragement and affirmation? Good morning, Cyril. It's good to have you here today. I have to agree with Trevor. I think definitely it is very easy to find a word of discouragement in our world. It is easy to turn on the TV and watch the news and feel discouraged by what's happening around us. I think often in our desire to be striving for better, our tendency is to, you know, either tear our own selves apart and discourage ourselves, or to forget the importance of encouragement and discourage our friends, our families, our children, the people that are around us. And so encouragement is so important. So I was thinking back over my own life and the people who have been encouragers, some of them really key encouragers in my life, and others just a small thing that made a big difference. So one of the first people I remember, and I'm pretty sure I've shared this in worship, her name was Mrs. Schott-Snyder. And I was probably about three when my sister was singing in the choir, and I would come and I was not old enough to be in the choir, but I would sing at the top. I would learn the songs and I would sing them at the top of my lungs, because I was, and not that I wanted, I mean, I guess maybe I did, but I just knew I wanted to sing and I wanted to join in. So she took my mom aside and she said, you know what, let her sing. And I joined the choir, and that was like so key for me. She saw something in me and she encouraged it. I think about other people in my life that have just come alongside and encouraged my journey, have seen something in me, and they didn't have to say anything, you know? They could have easily just walked on by. But they saw something in me and they encouraged me with that. And sometimes encouragement can be as simple as just a smile, reminding someone that they're not alone, that what they're walking through, we all walk through. And I really believe so strongly that in today's world, people need to know that they're not alone. They need to know that the challenges they are facing, that others are also, and so that it feels Like I can stand because I've got others that are standing with me that can pull me up. So I want you to take a minute of some time today to think about the people who have been encouragers in your life, the people that have supported you, and maybe you can even put them in the comment section. Who are the people that have been your encouragers that have gotten you to grow more deeply in your faith, have showed you gifts and talents that maybe you thought you had, but you needed someone to just kind of remind you that those gifts and those graces needed to be used. Who are the people that when you're feeling like you're ready to give up, they give you a call and they remind you that you are loved and that you are not alone. Who are the people that again and again remind you that you are loved and cared for? And maybe if they are still here with you, if they are still living, you can take some time this week to send them a word, a blessing, a thank you, a word of encouragement, because I'm sure they all need that as well. Trevor, I know he's got a prayer practice, but I'm thinking that it might be nice today, in addition to thinking about who your encouragers are, is to think about who you might encourage today as well. We were doing three at two, oh, was no, it was five. My goodness, I lose track. But we were doing five prayers a day, if you remember that. Five things to give thanks for when we were in Lent. So maybe today you can see if you can find five words of encouragement. And I want to encourage you, oh, there's one now, to think about how you can encourage yourself as well. Because I often think the words of discouragement that we speak most loudly are to ourselves. You know, we spend a lot of time reminding ourselves of the times where we have failed and fallen. We spend a lot of time reminding ourselves that we are less than, that we are not enough. I know we talked about that the other day. And what if one of those words or two of those words of encouragement today can be for you? Can you look in the mirror and say, you, Cindy Stauffer, are a beloved child of God? Except you'll say your own name. Yeah, that's I think a really hard thing for us too. And if we've lived in relationship with people where we spend a lot of time tearing them down, this is challenging. If people have continually tore us down, it's hard. But we begin by making steps toward a healthier way of understanding ourselves and our neighbor. So five, make it five today. Two for yourself, at least one for yourself. But five ways that you can be an encourager and see what that does for your own hopefulness, your own ability to see the goodness not only in you, but in your neighbor. So today, I want to tell each one of you that you are a beloved child of God. And no matter what you're walking through today, that you don't walk alone, that you are loved and cherished, that you are beautiful, and perfect, but God's not finished with you yet. Let us pray. Good and gracious God, we give thanks for the encouragers, the Barnabases in our lives that have seen something in us and have nurtured that, have offered us consolation when we were just ready to give up, have reminded us that we're not alone. Lord, we thank you for those spiritual mentors. We thank you for those family members, the mothers and fathers, the spiritual mothers and fathers, the mentors that have nurtured us and reminded us of our deep value. Lord, we thank you. We thank you for the Barnabases in our lives. Lord, we also lament the times that we have chosen words that bring and tear apart one another, and we have used those own words on ourselves. Turn us around today, Lord, that we might speak words of hope, that we might speak words of promise, that we might speak words of encouragement for each other and for ourselves. Guide us today that we might be Easter people, resurrection people, seeing the best, the beauty, the goodness of your world, and offering a word of hope to one another. We lift all of this up to you, Lord Jesus, as together we pray the prayer that Jesus taught his disciples. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. So I started today off with Kirk Franklin's I Smile. It's a, for me, it's this wonderful word of encouragement that no matter what we're walking through, that there are beautiful moments in each day, in each moment, to look around and give thanks for. And so we smile. And maybe today your smile is enough encouragement for another person. So go. And I encourage you to give five words of encouragement today and give thanks for the encouragers in your life. God loves you, and so do I. Bye, friends.